A little boy goes shopping with his father on Friday afternoon. While the father selects food for Shabbos, the child spies the candy aisle and happily wanders away. As soon as the father discovers that his son is missing, he begins searching the store. The boy, however, is totally oblivious as he contemplates the sour sticks and the lollipops. Soon he tires and thinks about hopping into the car and snoozing as his father drives home. His father, where is he? Suddenly the little boy can think of nothing else. He's lost and alone. And then he sees his father in a distance, peering down the aisle in search of him. He runs into his father's arms crying, "Daddy, Daddy, I found you." Like this little boy, we tend to wander away from our Father in heaven in pursuit of our heart's desires. For many of us, this defines our day-to-day life. How then can we rise to the level of tshuva and to reconnect with Hashem in the brief period of Elul through Yom Kippur? As in the allegory of the little boy, as soon as we realize our total dependence in God in every aspect of our daily lives, we are overcome with longing. The sins themselves have put a barrier between us and Hashem, and we feel the separation, the lack of connection. Our overwhelming dependence on God and the feeling of our disconnect are what spurs our reconnection. This reconnection is so passionate and powerful that the one who does tshuva is said to reach a level where even the righteous do not stand. A sincere desire to connect to Hashem can even bring a regular person to a very high spiritual level. There's a story about a Jewish shepherd who one Yom Kippur went to shul. Moved to tears by the solemn, heartfelt prayers, he asked what was happening, and he was told that on this day, God sits on his throne and seals the judgment of the world. The boy yearned to join in the prayers. However, he didn't know how to pray. Determined to give Hashem the best he could offer, he began to whistle the tune that he uses to gather the flock from the field. The other congregants were aghast at his lack of decorum, but the Baal Shem Tov silenced their scolding. The Baal Shem Tov said, "Until now, I felt our prayers being blocked as they tried to reach the heavenly court." Yet this young shepherd's tears and whistling broke through the barrier. Since it was so sincere and so pure, and as an expression of his love for Hashem that came from the depths of his heart. The Talmud teaches us that after the destruction of the temple, the gates through which prayer travels are sometimes closed, except for the gates of tears. When our tears represent the purest of our thoughts and longing, those tears can move worlds. When we cry like children and we say, "Have mercy upon us," the mere desire to come closer to Hashem merits his help. Hashem then implants the light of tshuva into our hearts, launching our ascent towards tshuva. Tears of regret and embarrassment are powerful. When they arise from the recognition that we cannot endure without our relationship with Hashem, we must truly believe that everything we have is from Hashem. Our health, livelihood, shidduchim, and our very life are entirely in Hashem's hands. In this era of the world problems that are greater than anyone can solve, in a world in which decadence is so pervasive, we must place our faith in Avinu Shebashamayim, our Father in Heaven. When that realization strikes us, it ignites in our soul the spark to do tshuva. Therefore, even the first stirrings of tshuva in our hearts merit siyata d'shmaya, heavenly help, which enables us to connect to our loving Father in Heaven.